Hi for Tuesday, February 2nd. This just remind you, I know videos don't play well on the screen when you're doing a screen capture, but just a note that we did put a link, we did put this on the blog, so you can look at it there. It's Nature by Numbers, and it's, you can see the beginning ones here are Fibonacci's. And then we also did a tweet, twitter.com/StockTiger, and you will find the link to it there. It's kind of a nice video about numbers and nature and so forth. So you might want to take a look at it. Okay, now where are we going? We are going to the market. This is a video we made after the market closed. It's not the video, it's just the it's just showing what you see here. You see the two lines down, just showing this isn't done on a 60-minute chart. Maybe we'll do it if it gets if it looks like it's going to go there after a day or so. But the first leg down from this high down to the low, as you know, a nice five wave down, and then we did a repeat five waves up right up to the 78.6 Fibonacci, hitting it today, and then coming back down. If this leg down is the equal distance to the last leg down on this chart, I don't know why it bounced up, but basically it could bring us down to that 11,803, the same as the January low. Of course, it would bring us down below the 50-day moving average, which would be a scare to everyone, and below the Bollinger Band, but it could take a while, maybe if it takes a week to get there. But if we indeed go down, we might not, but you know, we've said that we didn't like the fact that we had this higher volume on the down days than we did on the up days. That's just not a plus sign. The bounce was normal going up, but we need to see some more volume the next time moving back up. The other thing we mentioned is that normally the Dow is up, or the market's been up on the first of the month and down also on the last couple of days of February. And since that reversed, the last few days have been up, we said that probably just the whole thing's inverted, and that's just how it played out. It's quite often you'll see that something will just invert, and you get the opposite of what's been happening in the past. You know, like when you think something's going to break out and it can't break up, it breaks down the same way as it would have broken up. Anyway, here we've got the Dow 60-minute, if you follow that 60-minute chart. We did a video about it as well, showing how it got to the 78.6 Fibonacci. And it went exactly there, and it's one that we don't talk about enough, but we can't do it on stock charts. It doesn't offer that feature, so on this chart I can't show you, but we did in the video. We showed it on Ninja Charts, and they have it, of course. So on the way down, what we can show you is something else, and that is a 23.6, which, you know, is some people use the Fibonacci number 76.8 instead of 78.6. The reason is 76.4. It's the, if you take 100 minus the 23.6, you come out with 76.4. So it's the inversion of 20. So I can show that number by using this on stock charts. The point is, we do have a possible and legitimate Fibonacci point at 1204.891. I mean, I may be off a buck or two because I'm not exact on these placements, but you can see this is a valid number. We're showing it as 23. It would actually be 76.4, but it's the same thing. So there's a bounce, and you can see in a 60-minute chart we are below the lower Bollinger Band, so that is a possibility. Of course, they can do away with all of that just by gapping down if it's going to be on the downside, and of course it could gap up as well. Let's get on. We'll see. And you, here you see the breakdown. If you're following this at all, if you're trading on the futures, we posted the futures charts as well in the morning and during the day, and it was easy to tell when it's short. It breaks through a trading channel, you're short. I mean, it's very low risk, because if it comes back in the channel, you cover. But in this case, you can see even on the cash, it broke down, came back up and tested again, and then that was the second point to short, and it came down. Moving averages crossed as well. It wasn't very difficult to see. The problem was not knowing where it bounced, and you can see when it came back down to a Fibonacci here, where also formerly support, it tried to bounce for a while, but the moving averages didn't cross. It couldn't get above them, so it pulled down. You can see where it's left it is not a great shape, though it is at a possible support area, but we'll just have, you know, we don't know how it's going to open, and the opening is the key, because the overnight trading look at not the cash prices like this. Their charts are a little bit different. You can see on the SPX also, we broke through the areas of possible bounce support. We posted one down at S2, and it looked like it could bounce, and it tried there, and it looked good. We have a good bounce, and we can do it the next day, but then it bounced a ways, and then it got sold back down again. So if you look left, you can see there's a couple areas. There's an area there and an area there, possible support. We may have to retrace 100%. We'll just wait and see. It's not really... I don't think too important one way or the other. if you're trading properly and you're hedging in the open positions, and if things are breaking trends or breaking support areas, you want to leave them. You can get back in them. I mean, it's not like the days when you had to pay $300 or $500 per commission for a trade. You can pay, if you've got good broker, $1 to $7 or something. So it's no big deal. Anyway, the Qs, they didn't pull back quite as much, down to the 61.8 of the total move up, not of this recent move. But you can see it filled the gap, came down to a valid line. It could bounce there. It's below the lower Bollinger Bands. If not, we're going down, we're probably going back down to the same place it made a little double bottom bit before. Note, we're not talking about the upside, that any of these places could bounce, but we can't. We don't need to look at that unless we get some possible turn up. From the public page, we've got a few of the ones that, if you're short-term trading, they're basically mechanical, SKF, which is an alter short for the financials. So as they came down, this, of course, went up. And it broke through the trend line, and the moving averages crossed here as well. They came back down and tested the moving average again, and then it continued up and went above the gap and then filled the gap. And then above filling the gap, it continued, but probably filling the gap was enough to take some profits for one day. If you're trading a five-minute chart, you should be looking probably at one day for part, and if you hold over, you can hold part, but you should be, if you're basing your trading on 5-minute chart, then you should also base some of your profits on that. It makes sense. Okay, I'm trying to switch. Hang on. Sometimes my mouse does this, and I can't get it to get to the next one, and I know that, what is it? It's control plus the right arrow key, maybe. Hang on. So here we have the Russell, also in the 5-minute chart. Same thing. It broke through the trading channel. It came down, found some initial support where it was before resistance, and then it became support. It was a nice, perfect, valid bounce point, but it came back up to the broken trend line, a little bit above it. But as it came through it the second time through a trend line is a short, and you'll notice there was a little pop up on the Williams, and it came back down as well. So a pretty normal sell signal there. Next up, we've got, I don't know what we have. We can skip that one and get on to just make a quick note about silver. It popped up and made a new high during the day, and you can see it ran back up to just above that 161 Fibonacci number. That was where it had gone almost to before, and it did this time and broke a little bit over it. There is some figures. 127 would be about 35 and change. We'll have that figure for you tomorrow. We don't have it at this very moment, but you can see we're moving up, getting up to the top Bollinger Band, have not really gone over it as yet, so we could have a possible other day. The dollar hasn't bounced yet. You can see it's still underneath that trend line, which is not a very good situation. The gold, however, has finally broken above. It tried it 1, 2, 3 times, fourth time the charm, finally broke above that. Now we've got with this charting system, we can do a 161% projection, would be a 1508. Now if we did just a 127, because now it's closed over the top, it's made a new high. The last high was 1430.60, I show here, if that's accurate, and now we close at 14. We close $4 over that. So closing over that, we now have a 75% chance of hitting the 1463. That's a 127. The way I figure it, you just take the distance it traveled from 1305 to 1430, whatever that is, and then times 127%, you come up to 14. I think it's 1463. You can do the math, but that would be a better than even odds of. Way better than even odds of going up to that level. You can see on this bounce down here, we'd broken above the RSI. I'd gone above its trend line as well. And GDX, which I'm just having this mouse flutter problem. GDX gave us a signal, and when it did last week, and we said some people may want to wait because it just didn't look like it's ready to fall, but we've got to go with what we got to go. It's a mechanical trade. So put a short up there, right here, And then we didn't go long until the next line up, so we lost $1.50 in that. But that's the first loss since June 22nd. We didn't we don't have the records before then, but since June 22nd, so that's pretty good. And we've made more. We've made up for that on the upside, anyway. So things are looking good so far there. And of course, we'll exit it when it says to exit it. Okay. Now we go not back to the video, but instead we go to the additions. We're not going to do exact additions. We've got, let me just get rid of this just for a moment. It should pop up now. I've hit the right button. We're just waiting on it. All right, there we go. So the market was down, but not all the stocks were down. CBR was in the watch list. You know, it kind of broke for a flash on a Monday. A little bit up, and then it came right back down again, but it closed still above the days before. So during the morning, it hit that break, the buy point, and it continued up. It had very good volume. It had led the leaderboard as far as volume goes all day long. And in fact, we posted a note that you may want to take some profits when it got to this 523-525 area, and it may gap up, but still taking some the first day when you've got to think something up 13% and the market's down. So we do have some of them that have been moving up, but not many. Okay, so now what we're looking at is possibilities, and we haven't even prepared to watch this. We're just looking at some possibilities here, and we'll talk about them. Is CGR? These are all resources, you know. So obviously gold and other things have been going up, and gold made a new high. This has pretty good volume here, 1.5. We had quite a few stocks that are very low priced and low volume. They're not good to use, but this hit a high of 275, so it's a possibility going over that, or a little pullback as well on CGR. I'm not sure if we'll put even do a watch just because we've just got a few of these. We want to wait for a little shakeout. We don't like to jump in just when the market changes one day. I don't think it's a good idea to go short unless we have a trend, except for individual ones that you spot, because you can just go short the ETFs when you're fighting the trend, and we're still in a bull phase of the market. So why fight it? But GDX, even though we have the normal GDX, is the GDX Junior. And if you like to trade that one, you just see it's come at a possible level here, because it's got a pretty clean target up to a possibility of 41, even though we have other resistance in the way. But that is a possibility. Also, I noticed that cool, this, I don't think this made it to the watch list. Maybe it did. It came close to the last time down here, and something happened. I think it got away from us, or I'm not sure. Maybe we had it on the watch list and I've forgotten about it. But you can see it did well. I mean, it was down 3.73%, but it's hold its own. I'm pointing it out. It's one to watch if the market's reversed, because this one kind of holding its own in here, it could do okay. And also, since gold has been going, silver's been going up, SSRI is a possibility here. It would have been nice to have bought it in this area. But if it can hold within this 28.59 is that top, and this lower 27.35 in this area, it could be a buy with a stop underneath here. Or if silver opens up a little bit weaker, can hold this first breakout, then we can buy up to the second one. Or it could be bought on the break of the middle one up to the top one if silver continues to go. Note that Williams is not really overbought at the moment, so that could... That certainly has room to run. Of course, Williams can stay overbought for a long time. Now, just quickly, I'll just go over a couple of the ETFs. There's no particular buy point, just to refresh you of ones that you look at if for the few people that don't trade them too often. Even if you're not long, you can use them as a trade. If you're long on the stocks, you can use them just as a hedge. Just try and position the right amount that it doesn't matter. If one goes up and the other goes down, you want to be hold yourself even as the point of a hedge. If you want to do it for profit, then you buy more of the one that you think is going to be the winner. So point is, we're up higher a few days ago, but it started back up again. FAZ, and you know that's a financial 3x bear, so this really moves. So just be aware that it can be pretty volatile, but that's the point of if you want to make some quicker money on fast moves. And then we've got the small caps, TZA. I just wanted to show you that it had very good volume on the move up, and it closed right at the 20 days. So this as a possibility to break there and go up to the 50-day moving average. Write these down, and you can take a look at the charts and be prepared in the morning before the market opens to know what you want to do depending on what factors. TWM is also small caps. It's just a different way of trading it, and the chart is a little bit different, and the volume pattern's a little bit different. DXD is for the Dow, and this one is moving back up as well. Last time it was 1911, right now 1884. And once again, if these start going, if the market does pull back to the area that we showed you, then this could run back up to the 1950 area, which is the top Bollinger Band, or a little bit above it actually, but it's the 50-day EMA, so those targets would be possible. SMN's another one that has a possibility here of it before it twice touched the 50-day moving average, and this is basic materials short, and it could run to that 50-day as well. Obviously it could break out as well, but that would be the near-term target, would be just up to there. And I think that's all of those, and we have just one other stock that's more of a it came up by accident, and I'm only showing it because of that. I was looking at gold stocks, and I just looked at patterns, and I thought, oh, this one looks good, until I saw it, and I realized that 22 million, what? And then I realized, oh, it's not dollars down here. It's not even a penny. So it's whatever it is. It's 0.0045. It's a half a cent. So it's not really one we'd put on a recommended list. But because it is the 200-day, we thought, well, you know, gee, it's up 12% for the day. But I'm just pointing it out. I know there are some people that trade not sub dollar stocks, but sub penny stocks. So, okay, that's enough. I hope you have a good day trading. And Wednesday, I guess it is. So have a good one and enjoy the weather. Hope it's spring where you are. And we'll be back again tomorrow with maybe some more coherent ideas. Thanks. Bye.